Breaking now, Florida shooter's brother taken into custody. And the plot thickens. We are now getting reports that the younger brother of the Parkland Valentine's Day High School shooter Nicholas Cruz was committed to a mental institution. Local area media are saying authorities have removed someone Friday afternoon from the home of Roxanne Deschamps, who is said to be a longtime family friend of the Cruz brothers and took them in after their adoptive mother died of pneumonia in November of 2017. Under the Baker Act, you can have anyone held against their will for up to 12 hours for a psychiatric exam. It's not clear at this point in time if he was released or not. Via the New York Post. The younger brother of deranged school shooter Nicholas Cruz was committed to a mental health facility, according to reports. Authorities removed someone Friday from the home of Roxanne Deschamps, a longtime family friend of the Cruz brothers who took them in after their adoptive mother died of pneumonia in November, the Palm Beach Post reported. A friend of Deschamps confirmed Zachary Cruz, who turns 18 next week, was the person removed from the home. The younger Cruz brother was involuntarily committed under Florida's Baker Act, under which he can be held involuntarily for up to 12 hours for an involuntary psychiatric exam. It's unclear if he's been released. Nicholas Cruz left Deschamps' Lantana, Florida mobile home around Thanksgiving after he and Deschamps squared off over a gun. "He bought a gun and wanted to bring it into my house," she said in comments that have since been wiped from her Facebook page, the paper reported. Florida Baker Act explained. The Florida Mental Health Act of 1971, also referred to as the Florida Baker Act, is a Florida statute found under Chapter 394 that allows for the involuntary examination though of an individual through involuntary or emergency commitment. The Florida Baker Act was named after a Maxine Baker, a state representative, who had a very strong interest and much involvement in mental health issues, and served as House Committee on Mental Health Chair. She was also the sponsor of the Florida Baker Act. The nickname of the legislation, Baker Act, has led to the phrase Baker Act being used as a transitive verb, and the phrase Baker Acted being used as a passive voice verb, in order to invoke the Florida Baker Act to force the commitment on an individual. Although the Baker Act Florida is only a statute for Florida, the use of the term Baker Acting has become very prevalent as a slang term in other parts of the United States for involuntary commitment. Initiating the Florida Baker Act. The Florida Baker Act can be initiated by law enforcement officials, court judges, mental health professionals, or physicians. In order for any of these officials to enact the Baker Act Florida, there must be substantial evidence that an individual has a mental illness as explained in the Baker Act, or there is intent to harm oneself, others, or be self-neglectful as described in the Baker Act. These examinations can occur in over 115 different designated receiving facilities under the Florida Baker Act. There are many different possible outcomes after an examination of the patient under the Baker Act Florida. Some of the possible conclusions include releasing the individual into the community or some form of community placement, petitioning for civil commitment or involuntary inpatient placement, which must result in a hearing within 5 days, requesting assisted treatment orders or involuntary outpatient placement or outpatient commitment, or having the competent individual consent to voluntary treatment. The option of involuntary outpatient placement was added in the Florida Baker Act 2005. Admission under the Florida Baker Act. A voluntary admission under the Florida Baker Act happens when a person who is 18 years or older, or a guardian or parent of a minor, applies for the individual's admission to a facility for observation, treatment, or diagnosis. An involuntary admission under the Florida Baker Act happens after a court finds that either an individual is mentally ill, resulting in him or her refusing voluntary placement for medical treatment, or if the individual cannot determine by him or herself whether placement is necessary. An involuntary admission can also occur under the Baker Act Florida if the individual is not capable of living either alone or with help, and going without treatment will most likely result suffering due to the refusal to care or neglect or self-infliction of bodily harm as shown by evidence of his or her recent behavior. Lastly, if there are no other appropriate treatment alternatives that are less restrictive, the Baker Law allows for involuntary treatment. In a later interview, Chad Bennett, a family friend of the Deschamps, confirmed Deschamps and Nicholas Cruz had a falling out when she didn't want the gun Cruz bought inside a home which she owned. She then gave him an ultimatum and Cruz took the gun and left. Although it's not known if the gun he had bought is the same one which he used to kill those 17 innocent people. Not that it would have made much of a difference since the FBI was so busy trying to overthrow President Trump to actually do its job, but why didn't Deschamps notify the authorities that there was a deranged individual packing an AR-15 who decided to be homeless rather than giving up his firearm? Who knows, maybe one more report would have made a difference and the FBI would have taken a break from working for the Democrat Party and actually done their jobs, which is to protect the U.S. citizen. This all was a screw-up of epic proportions. Let's hope that at least something good is able to come out of it and maybe the FBI is replaced by an organization which is nonpartisan and actually does the job us taxpayers pay it to do. Don't you agree?